Hi everyone, today we're going to take a look at this portable USB solar charger from CDRKING, and this is meant to output up to 11 watts. So you can see it unfolds into three panels, and in the pouch here you'll find the port where you can plug in your USB device to be charged. Now there's no battery in this, basically it's use it or lose it. So you have to plug your phone in or your power bank or whatever you want to charge and it will immediately start charging. So let's start by plugging in this watt meter with a dummy load and see how much power we can actually pull out with this thing. And I'll start with it on the 1 amp setting. Okay, so I'll just angle it towards the sun and see what we can get. Now, I don't know if you'd be able to see this on the camera, but we're at 4.96 volts, 0.92 amp, 4.5 watts. So that is pretty good. Let's try switch to the 2 amp setting. And I'm going to try and angle this better to the sun because at the moment we're getting 1.2 amp, but the voltage is very low, 3.3 volts. So we're actually losing power here. We're at 4 watts. So I'm going to try and angle this better. Now, it's hard to show this on camera, but I've been trying various angles like this, various different angles, and I can't get it to work on the 2 amp setting. It basically just cannot generate enough power. And today is an absolutely perfect day. Let me show you. You can see we've got the ocean there. There's no clouds. If I look up at the sun, you can see it's absolutely perfect. So you couldn't get a better day to test this. So since I can't get a dummy load working at 2 amp, I'm going to try charge my cell phone. So I have my iPhone here. Let's plug it in and then we'll see how much power we can actually draw from this. What I'll do is I put my phone inside the pouch so it doesn't get absolutely covered with sand. And it also kind of helps to keep it out of the sun. So right now I'm drawing 0.91 amp at 5 volts, so 4.5 watts. So it can handle a 1 amp load with absolutely no problems, but it can't go as high as 2 amp. So it's okay for charging a cell phone or a power bank, and it's a fairly fast speed, but you're not actually going to get 11 watts out of this thing. Now what I'm thinking is maybe there is 11 watts worth of panels, but you can't actually get that much out. They just put extra there so that if there's low sunlight, you're still going to get enough to at least charge your cell phone at a good rate. That's what I'm thinking. Now, although this is a nice panel from CDRKING and it does the job, it is three panels, which is a little bit bulky because if you compare it to some competing products like this one from PortaPal, this is just two panels. And although it says 11 watts, I only actually get 7.5 watts out of this, but this is much smaller and much more portable than this one. So I'm guessing PortaPal are using premium solar panels to be able to deliver more in a smaller package. So if you enjoyed this video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks for watching.